Rashonda LeGrand is hoping for the best, trying to remain optimistic. She's the director and founder of Beehive Birth Consulting. They opened their doors in February, providing education and support services for soon-to-be parents.
And once COVID hit, everything changed.
She says they can still have their services virtually and in person, but because of all the changes, they're just trying to stay above water.
Because we were just starting, like, a lot of our revenue just poured into the startup. So we have not been able to recoup any of our startup costs at this time because our plans were to be able to have full chairs, you know, every, you know, day of the week and classes and things like that.
Rashonda tells me they did apply for CARES Act dollars, hoping to offset what they've lost in revenue. But she says the process of getting those funds can be a challenge for minority business owners.
If we are not in alignment, then we get overlooked. If we're not in networks, then we get overlooked. They want to look at all of these different platforms of how you have sustained yourself. But when you just get started, you know, it's like, I don't have 3 years of records to show you. I'm a new business.
Joanne Davis with the OKC Black Chamber of Commerce says Black and minority businesses have always faced hurdles. She says there's a few reasons they're denied help or overlooked in the process.
Minority-owned businesses, and I'm gonna encompass woman-owned businesses in this too, don't always have, and I've talked about this before, the access to the right kinds of capital. There's systemic issues that have not garnered us always the success of other people of the equal education, of equal pay, whether it's garnering loans, trying to open up other avenues of business because of relationships.
Davis says the chamber is working to help develop, advocate, and educate small minority businesses throughout the metro, and helps more of them know what types of documentation banks and other institutions are looking for. Information that helped business owners like Steven Nelson, who missed more than a month of work at the start of the pandemic.
Well, at the beginning of it, because the word essential, a lot of us in this creative space didn't understand if we could work or not.
He says one of the challenges as a minority business owner is not necessarily knowing which questions to ask, but to whom?
As a culture, as a society, as a people, we are sometimes left in the dark. Information is power, but when you don't have it or you don't know where to go get it or the right sources, then it comes very complicated.
He says after learning his business was able to remain open, he now had to create a space to make clients feel comfortable.
We started creating outdoor sessions, and we started using more of our telephoto lenses and telling people, hey, well, we can keep a distance, you know, 10 feet away.
But not all Black-owned and minority businesses have been as fortunate.
I've had a conversation with a restaurant owner recently, and here's the quote. We're barely hanging on.
Apollo Woods is the CEO of OKC Black Eats LLC, a marketing consulting company for Black-owned restaurants and small businesses. Apollo tells me he knows 3 Black-owned restaurants that have closed during the pandemic.
One being OKOCO. OKOCO was the first one that closed, and they opened, I believe, in January. They lasted maybe 4 months. One of our most popular and amazing restaurants, Off the Hook, their south location. Off the Hook is in that airport travel district. No one's traveling, no one's staying in hotels. The base of their support, now they have to make a tough decision.
And according to a report from the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, minority-owned businesses are more likely to be denied for a loan. Apollo says he knows some restaurant owners who were denied loans or even hesitant about applying for PPE loans because they felt it may turn into another debt. He says some of the issues they face stems from a larger problem.
We cannot keep having this conversation about the impact of COVID without talking about financial redlining, without talking about application bias, without talking about do our statutes support this type of initiative.
Joanne Davis with the Black Chamber did praise the OKC City Council approving $2.75 million going to the Minority Small Business Program for Black business owners who didn't qualify for CARES Act dollars. Paris Jones, KOCO 5 News.